Bye guys. Okay, I promised to do a new video for dipping cabs because the last one cuts out and it was well overdue. So I have pre-prepared the paint. I prefer to pour on freezer paper because after you've done your dips, you can let the paint dry and you have an acrylic skin to do more jewellery with the acrylic skin method. I've also got a variety of cabs. I've just cleaned the flat side of them with some rubbing alcohol just to get rid of any fingerprints or dirt or smears or that sort of thing that may affect the paint adhering to the glass. I also have my trusty chopstick with some. In Australia we call this blue tack. You may know it in the US as poster putty. And it's just stuck onto the end of the chopstick, which is what we're going to use to pick up the cabs. Okay, just to mention about my paint mix, I do it exactly the same as I do my paint pours. So that's paint, Floetrol, a little bit of water, and also your choice of silicone. I use the hair serum, which gives me a good range of cells. As you can see, this is just a swipe of black and white over my new global metallics in purple and cyan. Okay, so all we do is we just pick up a cab, just press the blue tack or the poster putty firmly onto the curved side and it should pick up fairly easily. Find a good area on the cab that you like. Let's see about over here. Now, you need to dip it in flat, not on an angle. So try and get it as flat as you can and dip it in all at the same time so that you don't miss any spots on the glass. And you want to try and be really steady with your hand so that you don't smudge, especially if you want the cell structure that you can see in the paint. So we just dip it straight down as level as we can. And once you can see that all of the cab is covered in paint, you just carefully, slowly lift it back up. And you'll see underneath the paint is starting to reform again and cause new cells. Now all I do with the dip is I carefully take it off the poster putty and lay it wet side up on a flat surface to dry for 24 hours. And then it's good to put into a tray or whatever you're going to do with it. I'll do a few more so that you can see the process again. Press it down firmly to pick up the cab. Find a nice spot that you like. Dip it in very evenly. Make sure the paint covers the whole cab, especially the edges, because you want to make sure that you don't have to touch it up later if you can avoid it. And same thing again. Pluck it off carefully. Put it wet side up on a flat surface to dry. Oop, that one's stuck to my finger. One thing that I posted about a couple of weeks ago, try and consider how you're leaving the paint after you lift the cab up. Now the ones that I've lifted straight up, you can see it kind of gives you like a star shaped or flower effect. Of course you can go back and dip some more cabs into those areas and you'll get a whole different effect again, not just the cell structure that you started off with. If you pick up and swipe to the side at the same time, you'll kind of get like a leaf shape or a line through the paint, which will give you another effect. You can, let's see, I'll do this one. You can pick up as you lift up and twist at the same time and you'll leave a different shape again. So that's just something to think about, because it'll give you more variety in your in your pour or your dip possibilities from the same pour, to give you a bit of variety so that especially if you're doing a lot of them, you're not going to have the same thing over and over. Unless, of course, if you're doing sets or something like that, or a bracelet, you might want the same thing over and over, which is great. I'm just going to do this one. It's going to have black and white, so that's going to be pretty cool. And I think that's pretty much it. If you've got any questions, leave them in the comments and I'll be happy to answer with whatever knowledge I have. Just a warning, as always, dipping is very, very addictive and you can do so many cabs in the one puddle of paint that, you know, you can go a little bit crazy. So be forewarned. Okay, that's all for now. Thanks, guys, for watching. Take care. Bye.